when the life slipped from a black teenager's body on a South London pavement 25 years ago, it was the start of a scandal which shook a society. But it was also the end of a life filled with promise. Stephen Lawrence wanted to be an architect. Violent racism put paid to those plans, but among those who have realised his ambitions, a quieter prejudice still stalks the path.
We've had to sometimes find that when we walk into the room, people look at us a bit, who are you? And a bit startled, and they don't know who we are on the project, and then realise, oh, you're the architect, OK, we can give you some respect now because you've actually shown us there's some value to what you do.
But if you had white skin,
I think it would have been a lot different, yeah. You can build a bit of frustration towards it and feel it's unfair. Why are we having to work twice as hard? But I guess we subconsciously accept it almost and accept that that's what the system does.
Had he lived, Stephen Lawrence might well have been a family man by now. The dad getting tea for his children here was born the same year as Stephen.
Right, you need to finish that first before you get an ice lolly.
Stephen Reed became a teacher, but this parent's biggest worry isn't racism, but another threat which comes from the streets.
I would say it's probably harder now being a black man than it was 15, 20 years ago, most definitely.
Because of the draw from gang culture?
Yes. They feel that that's the way of life. That's how they're going to grow. That's how they're going to mature. That's how they're going to earn their money. It makes my job more important as a black dad. It makes my work in life more important as well, because these are the children, like I say to you, in the next 10, 15 years, these are going to be our teenagers. And to be honest, in 10, 15 years' time, I'm hoping that we've had a dramatic change from now.
Stephen Lawrence was a talented young athlete. Perhaps he'd be a coach now at the club where he used to train, where it feels like the area has moved on from the time when racist thugs roamed the streets.
When you hear the name Stephen Lawrence, what do you think of?
I think instantly racism, definitely, because that was why he died. But times have changed since he was killed. You kind of get a feeling of being more accepted, especially as a black woman and a black person in society. I think there's just more acceptance of us.
But among this new generation of athletes, there is a sense that part of the legacy of the Stephen Lawrence case is still unsettled.
You feel like the police force, the Metropolitan Police,
yeah,
is an organisation which protects you or threatens you?
Threatens me. I don't feel protected by the police. I get stopped and searched because, I'm wearing a hoodie or I'm dressed in all black. It's like, I thought it was innocent until proven guilty, but it's like, I'm guilty and I've got to prove that I'm innocent.
Much has changed, of course, since Stephen Lawrence stopped coming to training. But along the tracks where his life might have been lived, if your skin is of a different colour, society might still treat you differently. Geraint Vincent, News at 10.